Welcome to the final episode of my series on how to get started on YouTube. In this video, we're going to talk about how to publish a video and how to make your channel grow. Let's roll the intro. For those of you who are new to this channel, I'm Luc Ben-Mahalford, a young photographer and filmmaker on a journey to become better at this art. In the first three episodes, we talked about how to plan, shoot, and edit a video, so I highly suggest you go watch them out before watching this video to get a better understanding of what we're going to be talking about. Before talking how to publish your video and how to grow on YouTube, I wanted to have a little emotional moment because it's actually really hard starting in 2021 on YouTube. Don't get me wrong, it's still a lot of fun creating these videos, but you're going to have to work really hard. There's going to be some up and downs, so it's really important that you're inside of this for the long term, not just for quick growth or to get some money quickly. My most recent videos haven't been performing as well, but that doesn't mean that I'm doing anything wrong. It simply means I have to wait and continue producing more content for the algorithm to pick up something like it did in the past. My most popular video has over 178,000 views, and I have a few other videos that have over 50,000 views. But I also have some recent videos that only got a few hundred views, so it really depends on the videos that you're publishing, and it's really going to be up and down. All of this to say that you really need to concentrate on the long term and not be here for instant growth on YouTube. Oh, and also just forget about getting 1 million views in 1 year. That's basically impossible these days to get on YouTube. Probably the most important thing when publishing a video is having a good title and a good description. I guess that most of you don't know that YouTube is actually the second largest search engine after Google. If you search for Google Pixel 4a versus DSLR, my most popular video is actually going to appear in the first place on Google and YouTube. If you're asking yourself how I did it, it's actually pretty simple. The answer is good SEO or search engine optimization. Here what I did is adding the keywords that are the most important inside of the title and the first phrase of my description to let know the search engine what they should be targeting when you do a search. So in this case, the important keywords are Google Pixel 4a, versus and DSLR. For our example video, we're making a review of the DJI Mavic Air, and here we're gonna wanna go inside of YouTube Studio to change the title because it uses the default title that is inside of the video file. So here we're gonna rename it to DJI Mavic Air, and we definitely wanna have this inside of the title because this is the most likely phrase that people are gonna use when searching for our video. So this is very important to think about what people are gonna type when searching for the topic you're talking about. For the title, we're allowed to add up to 100 characters, so I definitely suggest that you use as many as you think is useful to add more information because this is where YouTube is gonna be looking for more keywords and where the users are gonna be looking to see if it's worth looking at your video or not. So in my case, I'm gonna add here still worth buying in 2021. And this will know both the algorithm and also the users that this video is still valid in 2021, even though the drone was released 3 years ago. For the description, we're gonna wanna explain what is inside of the video in 2-3 phrases, but not more than that. In my experience, most users never read the description, so you're not really targeting for them. It's more targeted for the algorithm to let know the algorithm exactly what is inside the video, not just what is the main topic of the video, so it can help targeting afterwards the video to the right people. So I'm gonna do it right now, and we're gonna see the result. The next 3 points are very important. So first of all, don't use clickbaity titles. This was a trend a while back on YouTube, but YouTube is really cracking down on this. It's actually really easy for YouTube to know if you have a clickbaity title, because if people click on the video but don't watch it for very long, this is a clear sign that you're using a clickbait title and they're gonna shut down your video really fast. The second point is don't lie. You might not know, but YouTube creates automatically some subtitles for every single video that is uploaded. And the reason is not just for better accessibility, it's actually for YouTube to know what's the content inside of the video. So if your title and description says one thing, but the content of the video says something else, they're gonna know that you're lying inside of your title and description, so they're probably not gonna promote as much your video. And the third thing is that you shouldn't overthink it too much. The fact is that if you use something that is simple for the title and simple the description, it's gonna be easy for users, your viewers, and also the algorithm to understand what is inside of the video and allow them to understand if they wanna watch it or not in the end. The next most important thing are thumbnails. Gone are the days where you simply take a frame from inside the video. These days, if you don't have a great thumbnail, you're gonna lose people right away because most people don't even read the title or the description of the video. So your thumbnail needs to grab attention and also tell very clearly what the video is about. To create this thumbnail, we're gonna be using Canva. I personally use Photoshop for most of my thumbnails, but it's a little bit overkill when you're starting out. So we're gonna come here inside of Canva, create a new design, search for YouTube inside of the search bar right here, and select YouTube thumbnail. So now it's gonna open right away. And I took a picture using my Google Pixel 4 and the portrait mode of the drone to get a nice shot of the drone where we get a blurry background so you really have the subject as being the drone. So I'm gonna come here, upload the image. Okay, so now that the photo uploaded, we can add it to our design and just bring it up. So now the subject of our video is pretty clear using this image, but we're not grabbing the attention of people. So for this, we're gonna come inside of the text tool here, add a text. So I do like this one right here. So we're simply gonna click on it to add it here. We're gonna resize it, put it on the side here, and we're gonna add our question that we were asking. So we're gonna ask right here if it's worth buying in 2021. So now to add a bit more contrast between the text and the background, we're gonna go inside of effects here and add a drop shadow. So you could use something else, but this is actually gonna allow us to just make the background a little bit more clear and have a better separation between the text and the background. So now if you come back here, we just wanna make sure that the last thing is that we can actually see it even when it's really small. So we're gonna bring it down. And we can see that even when our design is small, the text is still very clear. And this is important because most people are going to be seeing your thumbnail on their mobile device. So you need to make sure that it's still visible when it's at a smaller size. Okay, so now we can upload our image right here. So we're going to come here, switch our thumbnail, use a custom thumbnail, upload it here, select, and now we're done. So the last thing we have to do for publishing the video is actually decide how we're gonna publish it. So usually what I like doing is uploading the videos a few days in advance just to make sure that everything works out and there's no problem with ads or with the subtitles or anything like that. And then I'm gonna go inside of schedule here and just select the date and the time I wanna have it published. So let's say tomorrow, and it could be so Saturday, and at let's say 8 a.m. So we're gonna select 8 a.m. for the time to be published. And now we're ready, so we're just gonna save this, and it's gonna automatically publish tomorrow at 8 a.m. I know one very popular piece of advice on YouTube is actually to use a schedule and publish your videos every single time, every single week, but I think that if you need more time to work on a video, or if you have a video that's ready before your schedule that's planned, I think it's better to publish them, because as long as you publish a lot of videos on YouTube and always continue publishing some, your channel is gonna grow, and it doesn't really matter if you're publishing them every single time, every single week. Now let's end by talking about which statistics you should be looking for inside of your videos, because looking only at views don't tell you much. Instead, you should be looking at CTR, which is click-through rate or retention rate for your videos. So click-through rate or CTR tells you how many people clicked on the video when they saw it inside of YouTube. So this is if they see it in their new homepage, if they see it when they're doing a search, YouTube is gonna count how many people clicked on it versus how many people just scrolled away without looking at it. My normal click-through rate is about 5 to 10%, but on very good videos, it can go up to 15 or even 20% in very extreme cases. But if yours is lower, it's not a big deal. To increase your click-through rate, you wanna focus on two things. So the first one is have a better thumbnail, and the second one is changing your title. So my rule of thumb is that usually, if after 6 or 10 hours of publishing a video, it's not performing as I expected, I might change the title or the thumbnail or both, and wait another 5 to 10 hours and change it again if it's still not performing. The thing is that you don't wanna be changing it every single hours because it doesn't leave enough time for the algorithm to try and target other people's afterwards. But if after changing it 2 or 3 times, the video still doesn't perform, I just stop changing it because that's just probably a video that won't perform, and I just stop stressing about it and start my next video. Retention rate is how long people have been watching your videos, and this is very important because the longer people are watching the video, the better it is for YouTube because they can sell more ads in the end. To increase your retention rate, you're probably gonna wanna look at other pretty important metrics, like where are your viewers coming from? What are the spikes and dips inside the video? So where are you losing people inside of video? Or where people are rewatching your video? What's your audience? So is it people younger, older? And all kinds of things like that can really help you build some better content for your next video. There's also a kind of balance you have to find between click-through rate and also retention rate, because if one or the other is really high but the other one is low, YouTube is not going to be happy because they're going to think that something is a bit fishy inside of your video and they're just going to stop promoting it as much. So you want to try and find a balance where both are higher but that there's not just one that's very high and the other one is very low. This is just very tricky to find the right balance. You also should never compare yourself to other people, because every single people on YouTube has different click-through rates, have different retention rates, and this is just perfectly normal that everybody has something different, because it really depends on the niche, the type of video you're creating, your audience, and not finding some things like that to depend on how your video is going to perform in the end on YouTube. I hope this little series on getting started on YouTube helped you create your first video, or at least inspired you to create your first one. I want to end this series by saying that growth, or even the numbers of view on your videos, really isn't the most important part. What is the most important is that you enjoy the process of creating videos. If you enjoy the process, you're going to be able to come out with more videos, and the more videos are going to come out, the more your channel is going to grow over time. So this is very important if you want to be able to sustain your channel. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know by hitting the like button below, and also consider subscribing by hitting the big red button for more content on photography and filmmaking. See you in the next one. Bye bye.